Welcome to Tangata Pasifika. Kamana Māori. Great to have your company.
Yes, Malo Lele, kia ora. On the show today, 80s hero Terry Teo has been revived, and Samoan actor Card West is relishing the role.
My mom was a Terry Teo. She's like, oh my god, Terry Teo. I love Terry Teo. I used to watch that when I was a kid. Now at this stage of
the tables are turned. Butterbeena and tattoo artist Tavita Mose inflicts some pain on Dave.
Welcome to the pain factory. Oh man, I'm not looking for major pain factory.
And it's a very different climate for Vanuatu rower Luigi Dalem as he prepares for the Rio Olympics at Lake Karapiro.
When they told me I will go to the Olympics, yeah, it's been big for me.
But first, here's your Pacific news brought to you by Seinafolava, Sanele, Chadwick.
Thank you, Mama. Thank you, JP. Well, how to raise the prosperity of Pasifika people was the focus of a meeting between Pacific business community leaders and Treasury bosses in Auckland on Wednesday. Treasury Secretary Gabriel Makhlouf and some of his top officials were on hand to hear from the community. It's their job to advise government on what's going on in the economy.
We believe that the best way of ensuring our advice is as comprehensive as possible is by going out and listening to as many people across New Zealand as possible. So coming and talking to the Pacific community and its leaders is part of improving our job.
Discussions ranged from living standards, economic underachievement to the lack of housing. Treasury's key Pacific advisor says it's important the community continues to talk about economic issues.
We can't afford to have a significant community of New Zealand not contributing to its fullest possible economic potential. And the conversation now is really beginning.
One measure of the precarious economic state of the Pacific community is a net worth, where the average for Pākehā is $114,000, $23,000 for Māori and just $12,000 for Pasifika. And we'll look more at the issue of prosperity or the lack thereof later in our Talanoa. Well, Samoa Language Week is over, but the culture was on show again this week as communities were treated to a visit from Samoa's head of state. His Highness Tui Atua Tupua Tamasese Efi visited the Malaiola Centre in Mangere to highlight the benefits of Samoan culture and the need to carry on the legacy of their ancestors. Organiser Tanoa'i Reupena Michael Tanoa'i hopes the experience will resonate with New Zealand-born Samoans.
One of the guys that does a lot of work for us is, you know, play Tupac, hit him up, all our generation, in other words, say that, but you're Samoa, no one knows it, eh? So hopefully this is the start of some kind of movement, just to, you know, get everyone just to be proud, eh? Our culture's beautiful, we have dance, we have all these other things that we're proud of, but this is the heart of it, eh?
The event was hosted by Epiphany Pacific Trust's Anganu'u Wha'a Samoa 101 program. To Tonga now, where children will no longer go to school hungry thanks to a Good Samaritan who's providing free lunches twice a week. Dr. Tanielu Balu and his family provide free breakfast to more than 100 students at the Kolomotu'a Government Primary School in Tongatapu. He says his granddaughter told him how children were going to school without breakfast.
I know from experience that there are children who need a good breakfast. So we decided to provide this for the whole school. When you see children who probably would not have the opportunity to have breakfast in the morning for various reasons, I'm so glad that they come.
Dr. Palu says around 20% of Tonga's population live below the poverty line, and now other schools across the kingdom are looking at running a similar program. A long-forgotten part of New Zealand's relationship with the Cook Islands has been uncovered in a new book. The Last Recruits tells the story of the 30 young men selected from the islands to serve in the New Zealand Army just after the Cook Islands attained self-government in 1965. From that group, 9 men went on to serve in the Vietnam War, including the uncle of author and journalist Moana, Moeka'a.
I had an uncle who was actually involved in this group. He was a very close uncle of mine while I lived in New Zealand. So I just thought it was appropriate that, hey, you know, this is just one of hundreds of stories, you know, to do with Cook Islanders involved in, you know, the military in New Zealand. And, you know, I thought this is a story that needs to be told, because if you don't tell it now, nobody's ever going to tell it.
While many Cook Islanders have served in the New Zealand Army over the years, only at the outbreak of the First World War and in 1966 have soldiers been actively recruited in the Cooks. And finally this week, the country's first online telethon has raised more than $100,000 for the Te Puea Marae in South Auckland. New Zealand musicians gathered on Auckland's Kay Road for the Music is Love, Hope for the Homeless fundraiser, which brought a number of artists on stage, including Tomorrow People, Swiss and Three Houses Down. Singer Charlie Pomee says he hopes the concert will help get families into homes.
Our children need beds, our children need their own space to run around, you know, have their own free agency. So I'm here hoping that the funds that we make tonight will get families into homes.
The concert was live streamed to 9 countries where viewers could donate money online. And that's your Pacific News this week. Back to you, Marama and John.
Thank you. You actually went along to that concert the other night.
It was very good. It was cold, but when we went there, it was nice and warm. Reggae music, it brings out the summer in everyone.